What's up, YouTube? This is the Synchronization. I am Kale.
I'm Nate.
I'm Felix.
I'm not.
He isn't.
I'm here.
Well, he's not wrong.
Welcome to the...
Wait for it.
Hold on. Wait. There we go. Metal Gear Rising Revengeance playthrough.
We did this before.
Many a time.
No, we didn't. Shut up. Anyway.
Yeah, yes. Metal Gear Rising Revengeance.
So who has experience with the Metal Gear series?
My mom.
Let's see. Considering it's this game, you could say I don't know Jack. Oh, I don't think anybody else knows that.
Huh. I'm so proud of you. Anyway,
Actually, Noob, could you hand me the gamepad?
Uh-oh. Yeah. Oh, Nate has to look up his data.
Yeah, pretty much.
It's pronounced Dita.
It's actually pronounced fuck you.
Dita. Hey,
fuck you too, man.
Yeah.
I thought you were going to say Dita.
Nobody has any
experience in Dita. I literally played... I know, like, faint glimpses from my childhood from when I watched my stepdad play it and, like... 5 minutes I played it before you guys got here yesterday. And not even this, it was two when he first popped up.
Well, by some asinine chance that you don't know about this game, this is the latest of the Metal Gear series so far, not counting Ground Zeroes because technically it's just a chunk of Metal Gear 5, so...
Yep.
You need to talk about that $40 demo.
And we don't talk about the fact that game... Oh, God, it's not even going to have Kojima's name on it.
It's also the latest in terms of timeline. This comes after Metal Gear Solid 4, which happens after everything else.
Yep, for a bit of a more... Well, not really all that in-depth, but for a bit more. It started out as Metal Gear, then became Metal Gear Solid, and is now Metal Gear Rising. And is that just the names that all future games are going to go off of at this point?
No, this is just this game.
Yeah.
Is there going to be a Metal Gear Rising series, or is it just this and nothing but?
Well, it's been a long time since this came out, and they've had a lot of time to do it. The last game they did was Bayonetta, I believe. So...
They are still thinking of making
a sequel. Yeah, they might make another one.
There's a possibility of a sequel, but I don't know if that involves Kojima and the whole Konami bullshit. Mm. Yeah. So, yeah, that shit. But,
There's no more Snake, by the way.
They can make it about a different character.
This is Raiden. He debuted in Metal Gear Solid 2.
Sons of Liberty.
And that's the only game I've played for like 10 minutes at most.
Same here.
That's the most experience I've had with the Metal Gear Solid game here. Espionage is... Okay. It's not that I don't like stealth games. It's that...
You're noisy!
To me, stealth games, or at least stealth sections, should be reduced to sections. Like, I can't play an entire game dedicated to being stealthy.
I can, that shit's tricky half of the time, though.
Like, I played Deus Ex, and, like, I tried to do an all-stealth run. It just gets frustrating after a while.
Just gotta be careful, man.
It's not even that it's hard, it's just I get bored. Like,
I kill things.
Kill people.
What's the point of Deus Ex?
It is when he plays it.
I hate to see you play Dishonored.
Well, unlike Metal Gear and Deus Ex, you have the option to either, like, run and gun and kill everybody, or you can be stealthy, but, like, I tried being stealthy, and it's like...
I tried to run and gun. I kept running out of ammo. And as you can see here, this is Raiden doing his thing.
Yep.
And that there's Snake. See, this is Metal Gear.
I wonder if, Justin the same thing as the cover sometimes. Because, like, Raiden is kind of more ninjish. And Sam is like a
no. It's
samurai.
Just
something.
He just has something to do with Wynn. That's it.
But yeah. So yeah, the next game in the series is coming out until what is that? September.
Yeah.
Phantom Pain.
I think. Please place your pre-orders today.
Yes, for the last.
Support. Did you? Oh wait.
Oh wait, the smile.
the most shit eating of the grid. This game is a factory for those.
But yep, Phantom Pain will be the last game that Kojima's involved with. At least in terms of Metal Gear.
And isn't it like the second game in its chronology?
What?
Phantom Pain.
Because
it has Big Boss.
Yeah, because you play as Big Boss right here.
I don't know about Big Boss is usually the earliest.
No, it's actually a bit further down there. The timeline goes Snake Eater, Portable Ops, Peace Walker, Ground Zeroes, The Phantom Pain, Metal Gear, Solid Snake, Metal Gear Solid, Sons of Liberty, Guns of the Patriots, and then Rising Revengeance.
So, yeah, well, God, it's like what, the Zelda timeline. Everything's a prequel.
Yeah, so...
Well, remember, Snake's dead. Yeah, everything
pretty much, if you want to know the timeline, who are you playing as? If you're playing as Big Boss, you're playing pretty damn early in the timeline. If you're playing as Raiden, you're going pretty damn late.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If you're Snake, you're in the middle.
Yeah, Phantom Pain is pretty much right smack dab in the middle of the fucking timeline. But even without Kojima, they're still going to be making more Metal Gear games, so can't wait to see how that's going to go.
So here's a question. Where the fuck in that timeline did Raiden become a cyborg?
Because somewhere in between two and four.
Well, duh.
Well, there you go.
There's your answer.
I mean, what?
I don't know. After he was introduced in Sons of Liberty, the only other game that, like, is in between them is Guns of the Patriots and then this game, so...
And he was a cyborg in Guns of the Patriots.
Well, I know that, but what I'm actually asking is, like, what events led to him becoming a cyborg?
Something about protecting the lady.
There's like a good 5-year time gap between Sons of Liberty and Guns of the Patriots.
So after Sons of Liberty, he just went home and was like, you know what, I'm going to get that plastic surgery I always wanted.
No, it was something about like his body getting damaged heavily protecting some lady and daughter, I believe.
Maybe we'll make a game about it.
Once we play Metal Gear Solid 4.
That game they tell you what happened?
Yeah.
Okay, then. So... No,
once you play 4, everything is explained.
Yeah.
So you may have noticed that I am not being some Gene Louis, but... That is because Metal Gear Solid Vengeance is not about stuff. Nope. It is about murder. Murder and awesomeness. And awesome murder.
And murdering awesomely?
Why should I? Can't take that on the street.
Oh, and the best physics for cutting.
Yeah.
The leg was inside of it.
So does anyone want to explain the fucking gameplay style here?
It's hack and slash.
You press the button, you cut the guys up.
You press the button, you cut people.
But the and then you press the other button. This
game really wants you to let you know it. Yeah. Like, just go into... Oh, wait, no.
Give me a shot.
That's no, like, he got it.
Not that. It's going to be in a minute, but I want him to show up because I'm bouncing.
Well, I kind of can't at the moment.
That's what I mean. They'll see it in a minute.
No, you could have done that. Every time it glowed on blue.
Oh, God.
No, I just need to hold.
Yeah.
No, you could hold out.
That art.
Yeah, the art's pretty good.
No, this is the original Raiden art. My God.
Yeah, that's how it was. That's how Metal Gear has their art in the beginning.
God, it looks like old Final Fantasy art.
Born in that kind of day and age.
That Final Fantasy art is still being used.
Yeah, it is.
Which, in my opinion, isn't a good thing. Like, no offense to that artist, but it should have been. His art is ugly, but, you know, the way he draws his characters make it. I just remembered, I don't have to do any of this shit.
Yeah.
Fuck, man. Why you gotta murder all those people? They have families.
I'm sorry. Murder is fun.
They had children.
Oh, no, the clones are attacking.
Yeah, this is the first and probably going to be the last Metal Gear game that I've played in media.
Also probably the last where there's a Metal Gear.
Although I do feel bad because, you know, this is like, you know, the latest in the timeline. The whole presence of Metal Gear doesn't affect me because this is like my first time seeing it. My second time seeing it because the first time I saw it was Metal Gear 2. But I didn't do anything yet, so it's like good.
Yeah, if we actually played in order of the games, this would probably be more hype than it is now.
More like, oh my god! But no.
I actually have a question about the Metal Gear series.
I have an answer, but it probably won't be the right one.
Have all the games in the series been ported to America in a timely fashion?
Dogs. I'm not sure.
What the hell was that?
He was right.
Because a lot of games that like we'll probably be playing either. Well, pretty much all the games in the series might not have. Oh, what?
Oh wait, another green.
Oh, there it is, right there.
Oh,
the shit-eating factory.
Wait, doesn't he have another one?
Scat flavor.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure they've all been imported right around the roughly time and fashion.
Okay.
I actually think Kojima may have made some of them while in America.
That means we got it first.
Well, I know that this game never got an Xbox 360 port in Japan.
What?
That's because the 360 doesn't it isn't selling in Japan.
The 360 is an American title. It's an American console, I swear. It's the most American console.
Yeah, that's why they don't like it. They go with Sony or they go with Nintendo. They look at that.
Ha! 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 That was a joke somewhere.
What?
Who do you want the Prime Minister? I want him dead. So who's that guy?
Nate, you are something else.
He's a cyborg. He's certainly best cyborg.
Actually, who's either of these people?
Well, one of them's Raiden.
Yeah.
Kind of.
Oh, yeah. I asked this question before. So, they're cyborg bodies. How do these work? Are there human bodies covered by a cyborg suit?
No,
or
it's
are
a
they
cyborg
completely
suit.
Mechanical?
It's cyborg. It's usually half and half.
Some of them are in a suit. Some of them are like it's more integrated inside their like flesh and stuff.
Because the thing is, like, there's no evidence anywhere in this game other than after this tutorial.
That like Georgia's heads.
Other than like a couple minutes from now, that like they have actual bodies under them. Because spoiler alert, Raiden gets his arm chopped off and he like bleeds profusely. So.
Okay. He looks.
These things are fucking everywhere. What the hell?
He looks different right here from like what I've seen from before. I guess just because.
This game, they look much bigger than what they actually are.
This is not.
I'll talk about Raiden.
Yeah, this is Zandetsu. This is proof that this game is a fucking hack and slash. Because it wants you to remember.
Japan
puts the game in slow motion just so you can fucking jerk off to the hacking and the slashing.
Oh, so much that you can lag the game.
Oh yeah. Why can't every just hack inside the remote just like that? Literally all of them just have something like that.
They don't want to pay for the special physics.
Are you kidding, man? I paid like 10 times the money for that.
Press R1 to ninja run.
Is that just R1?
Yes, ninja run. Because it makes more noise somehow. Yeah. Can I get rusty with the parrying?
You just parried it.
I know I parried it, but I was having a hard time doing the parry again.
I'm really bad at the parry. Fuck this game's parry.
Platypus.
Even with lock on, it's still annoying.
Did they change the way he looks at after the scene or something?
Yeah, after the scene? Spoiler chest.
Okay.
Yes. Oh, yes.
That's why I didn't
recognize him. He gets the face armor, too, after
that's
this.
Why I didn't recognize him.
Yeah.
Oh, you've seen the black armor.
Oh, yeah, you get his chin, too. I swear to God.
Why?
It's not the chin. The way he looks, man.
This or in the new body?
In this, right now. He just looks off.
I think I get why they went through with this new look, but, like, the way it kind of fits with how the story goes, does not. Pretty much, I get the impression that they may look at Lady Miller to the color side of the game, which, in reality, Raiden actually is. But...
Well, yeah, I mean, like, as he is right now is how he was in 4. More detailed, mind you.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, yeah, but in 4, the reason why he was angry, everything was resolved, as far as I know.
Well, it was resolved in 2.
I don't know, apparently I thought his girlfriend was cheating on him or something.
Oh, there we go.
Oh, here it is. Yeah!
Man! The sun comes up! When the lights
on the line! Oh, yeah, if you didn't notice, it's totally rocking soundtrack in the background. Yeah.
The words I know.
It's the most famous song of this game.
Also, split
still fapping to those cuts, huh?
Oh, yeah.
I see what you mean. He does just look off.
And look at that ass. That's kind of what prompted my question from before. It's like, is there a real ass under that?
Who
or is
knows?
That the real ass?
Well, wait. It is his real ass. Buns of steel, man.
Oh. Ha!
She do.
Look at that shaky camera.
Shit, what was her name?
I don't know how, but last time I did, or not the last time, but when I played this casually before, I caught up with him and still didn't catch him.
Scripted event.
Yeah.
Don't you hate those?
When the game glitched out, he like stops.
He's so fat.
You're too fast.
It's also that, like, he's fat. So if I wanted a cyber body, wouldn't you want a slimmer
Maybe there's more stuff underneath all that fat, like another sword.
Maybe there's like issues because his head is already fat.
Maybe he's hungry.
Yeah, maybe when they were making the cyborg body, they put his head on top of it, and it's like something's just off.
He needs a lot more support.
It's like a potato on a pencil.
Didn't we just kill that thing?
No, we just cut its arm off.
Yeah, he just chopped off the fucking blade.
Wasn't nature. I should probably
get the leg.
Yeah, too.
Jump!
You lied to me, Joe!
Jump!
No! You lied to me, Joe!
Harry!
Maybe that's why they gave you a new
chin. That almost didn't work.
Maybe this right here is why they gave you that new chin, because you chopped off this thing. Maybe it was like a trophy.
I took his chin.
You know what, maybe...
You killed it, and then you carved it for pieces.
Yep. Turned his chin into my own.
Because now that you say that, his armor does look like the new Raiden body armor.
Exactly. Now you're Raiden! I get it!
God damn it, Cam.
You knew they're his guns. Now all he can do is bite.
Speaking of that, why the fuck does Mortal Kombat still insist on pronouncing Raiden's name wrong?
Maybe it's a different Thunder God.
Hmm.
Well, they spelled it differently in frickin' Mortal Kombat 2. What? It was actually spelled Raiden.
What? Why?
I don't fucking know.
Exactly, why? R-A-Y.
Raiden.
Oh.
But they changed it back.
Time to finish that bastard off.
Is
run on the missiles!
Is Mortal Kombat just that stupid then?
Yes. Because
they just stopped giving a fuck.
I don't know. I've
them, it'll always be Raiden.
Okay, as a matter of fact, I'm going to answer that question. Yes. Why? Because they decided to put in both Freddy and Jason in two separate games.
Seriously.
That they had the fucking opportunity headed to them on a platter. No, we're just going to put in Jason after Freddy. Gotta leave that shit to Death Battle to finish up now.
Yeah.
But Freddy's dead.
Oh. What?
Like, the thing is that, like, a lot of English, like a lot of, like, English, like, games that have, you know, English dubbed and whatnot, tend to pronounce Japanese names wrong. Even when the voice actors in question have previously worked on other works in which, you know, said names would have been pronounced correctly.
That happens.
It's like ignorance. It's just stubborn.
Yeah, but...
Like, you know it's wrong, but you still...
Like how in Super Danganronpa 2, they pronounce Kazuya's name Kuzu Ryu.
What?
Yeah, his name is Kazuya, but they pronounce... But the voice actor pronounces his name...
Separate names?
Yeah, Kuzu Ryu, even though his voice actor has worked on other animes before, and has pronounced his own name correctly before, so it's like, why would... What?
Good job, guys. Oh, here's the other shit-eating grin.
It's like the fucking voice directors are just like, I don't care, it's pronounced this way.
My name.
Drunk.
I'm the director, bitch.
Or...
Damn it, Shaq, why are you here?
This is the most easily amused Shaq. Motherfuckers I've seen ever. Oh. That's the guy from Metal Slug.
I see who did the motion capture for the Titans.
Wrong game, man. You're supposed to be in Metal Slug, not Metal Gear.
I missed him.
What do you mean you don't know?
Which guy are you talking
to? The guy with the cap.
He's a ninja.
I'm a ninja. I'm a fucking ninja.
Oh, it's hilarious.
Train fight.
He's headed for the front of the train. Enter him.
No, really?
The scene coming up is odd.
Ish. You mean because of how stupid it was?
Yeah, it's like, what was the point of any of that?
Platforming, woohoo!
Not even, I'm just holding a button and it's doing itself.
Yeah. That sounds like a
fabulous
treat to me.
No, it's more like
I'm designing something for my grandmother.
I'm so sorry.
Why?
Okay, so they kidnapped the president or vice minister.
Prime minister.
Prime minister, there you go.
The vice minister.
They kidnapped him, chained him onto a train, threatened to kill him.
Did
almost
that.
Kills him, does not kill him.
That's all like...
Almost kills him again. Proceeds to not kill him. I don't hear any speeches about that. Even Sam knows how bullshit this is.
And now we're gonna kiss.
Yeah,
kiss. He changing.
That was shit eating good. It was a slim one, but it was there for a second.
Oh no, he had an O face after this, remember?
Mind if I got in? Ah! Oh, Sam, you're such a cut up.
He's a cut up as the rest.
Yeah.
And then
oh!
And then the girl. Wow.
Father, do!
Let me clean my blade. I need this black guy off here.
Father! I think he's mad.
He's gonna smile again. Just zoom in on his face and have him smile again.
I don't agree with what he did there.
Nor do I write like it. I knew it. Mentos, the fresh maker.
Oh God!
Works even with metal
teeth. I don't know. I don't think the shit eating grin is as bad as Shaq in those fucking Gold Bond commercials or whatever it is.
That's just his pure.
He's the king of them, man.
That's his natural.
If you ever
born
see Shaq dirt smile, there's an automatic advertisement no matter where he is. He can smile. In the
I'm
kind of
mad that's what he's hung down to. Just like, oh, I'm not playing basketball. I'm not being basketball anymore. What the fuck should I do? I know. I'm gonna advertise lotion.
Stop winning, KO. You can't.
What?
Yeah, this fight is unwinnable.
Really?
Yeah, it's one of those. You have to know how good the person is against you.
Yeah. So he's gonna whoop your ass.
I honestly dislike unwinnable boss fights.
By the way, the fact of how fast this train is moving and you were clinging to the ceiling for a good second there, shouldn't you not be on this train anymore?
That's a long train, man.
That's what she said.
I am not a fan of unwinnable boss fights.
I'd never seen that attack he did.
Okay. You have to do them. Like, I'm not saying no Grassy does, but...
So I'm not the only one that saw that, right?
Yeah.
I actually haven't seen that before.
Like, fuck you, fuck you, fuck you, fuck you, fuck you, I'm boss.
Like, in case like, what,
fuck,
like,
fuck, yeah, fuck you, fuck that.
Huh? Are there any games you'd say have done them right?
Well...
Ow.
That's a good question.
Like I just like
I thought you should have been one getting actually chopped up there.
Like I just like don't see the point of them. Like why are you gonna sit here and make me like tap all the buttons and do all this and play through this when I'm going to lose anyways? Why not just have this happen in the first place and just you know make me skip all the prelude to this if this is just what's gonna happen in the end anyways?
Cinematic.
Yeah, that's fair. I can't think of a. All right, pretty much. My idea, alright, if you have to have an unlovable boss fight in your game...
Have the option if you do win?
Yeah, yes? Wow, my train of thought is gone. Ah, train! my ideal scenario would be, instead of making it unlovable, just make it stupidly hard. And if you somehow do succeed, like, just skip an award or something.
Oh, look, his sword's on fire. Soul Calibur, anyone?
No.
No, fire versus lightning, dude.
His
sword's on fire and Soul Calibur.
Ooh, the gun that shoots the sword.
Unblocking moves, yeah.
You do that.
Yeah, that's why you can't parry anything he does. Oh, yeah, fuck your arm.
You tried to block it.
Oh, wait, come on, KO. Obvious joke.
You've been
disarmed.
Yeah!
Yeah!
See,
an air horn.
See, the reason why I appreciate that line from DBZ at Bridge is that, like, everyone has thought of that joke already.
Wait, you cut off my arm, man. That's not right. You're right. That's left. No!
Come on, hit me. Hit me.
Split them wide open.
He killed you and it did nothing.
He's just playing with you now.
Yeah.
Come on, I tagged you. Now you gotta tag me.
He's a shit-eating grin.
What are you waiting
it's
for?
It's like he's the player.
He's
fucking with you. You are his toy.
Like,
it's like when you gimp somebody in the game, no matter what game it is, and now you just start fucking around with them.
Raiden should be out of blood right now.
Honestly, the only thing that I feel is worse than an unwinnable boss fight is a boss fight that's, you know, when you're playing it, it's normal, and then you win, and then you lose anyways.
Yeah.
Those are the worst.
Yeah,
hate ones.
Too. Yeah, it's like when you win and you still lose. It's like, what the fuck was the point? I whooped your ass three ways the Sunday.
Oh wait, speaking on your saying on if you've seen a hopeless boss fight done right, I want to say this guy as hopeless boss fight.
Which one?
You know, when you're forced to like fight like 17 level 80s.
Early on. And then they bring in the rest of your crew to help you afterwards.
Snake reference though. Oh yeah.
That's winning, huh? Yeah.
And like there is an option if you win, it just cuts to the next. Area, and if you lose, you get the scene where they help you.
Yeah.
Or how about, like, an unwinnable fight where you're fighting multiple enemies, and say you're playing an RPG, like, instead of just putting you in a scenario where, oh, this guy's just gonna kill you and there's nothing you can do about it, just give him a bunch of, like, mini-enemies for you to kill so you can get as much experience as possible before dying.
This sounds like Castle Crashers.
Just something other than, fight him. I'm not going to tell you that it's hopeless, not going to show you that it's hopeless, you're just going
to
figure it out
on your own. Oh yeah, no one wants to do the waste of times.
Flares, that thing everyone uses, I didn't expect those.
Yeah, and then there's like some boss fights where like you literally have to just sit around and wait for him to kill you.
That too.
And then if you win, like especially if it's a new game plus type of scenario, all you're doing is moving to the you lost scene faster. It's like, well, thanks.
Yeah, that's the best way to put it.
Like, why not just show us a cutscene of them fighting? I don't have to do anything.
He bled out.
Okay.
Raiden, more like Raisin.
Are we gonna scream his name three times?
No.
Raiden?
That's when I die.
Oh. It's like one of my Japanese enemies.
Hey, double S!
Oh, damn.
Does that mean it's not a pure, though?
Yeah.
You got hit. So,
that's not fair.
I got shot.
Yeah, that wouldn't count. Yeah.
Three weeks later.
Yep.
You know how much they worked for that, Chin?
Yeah.
That was the entire budget.
Yeah.
Of this game.
That Chin, like, everything else is made up by brain and entertainment.
Well, duh, remember, like we just said, the body was just made of the scraps of the Metal Gear Ray he beat up.
They had to pick up those pieces, you know.
3 weeks is enough.
The next piece to your optic now. Yes, I should hope so, huh? I mean, how does it feel? To fly like a bird.
Like a bird strapped to a remote.
I'm so rushing.
Yeah.
Are there any Russian spies?
Yes, so many of them.
Alright.
They're all Russian spies.
This Duke's her.
My name is Doctor. Professor Doctor.
Doctor Professor Doctor.
MD, PhD, WebMD. Oh my.
They've been naughty. I must confiscate them so they can't use them again.
They still have the right hand. They're not busy on weekends.
Yeah. No!
Sitting at the left hand of the devil, or whatever the fuck it is the Christians used to say. Yes, I agree.
We know, right? Look how bright it got.
Oh, yeah.
So, who are they trying to stop here?
Remember that guy?
Which one?
Yes, I remember. One.
You know, that guy.
So the
fat head.
Oh, the big body guy?
Yeah.
Oh, no, not him. He's not here.
Yet.
Oh.
Sam?
The other guy.
I don't know, the guy that just shot the firearm.
No, the other guy.
The president?
The point is, we're going after a guy they haven't introduced yet.
Oh.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Technically, he is correct.
Is that the Jamaican guy? I think it was Jamaican.
Oh, he's just black.
Racist.
Yeah.
Damn.
Not everyone with braids are Jamaican, Nate.
Yeah, they are.
Not all Jamaicans are black, Nate.
Yes, they are.
You're making me mad.
Oh, he's back.
There he was introduced.
You know that guy.
Oh, no.
Of course.
Who the hell? Manny's killer.
Is that the guy they just killed?
Yeah.
Okay.
The guy they just kidnapped, let go, kidnapped, and then killed.
Okay. His name is Jetstream Sam.
Yeah.
The only problem I see. So did you base your Monster Hunter character design off of him?
What?
Your character in Monster Hunter. They look damn near exactly the same.
No, that's just the armor, dude. I based my character off of Space Dandy.
They look pretty damn similar, though. I was supposed to talk about the face with that grin.
The shit-eating grin. I picked it because it was the shit-eating grin. I picked the hair because it was dandy.
So dandy. So dandy.
Raiden's about to do a signature attack from Mortal Kombat.
I don't get it.
Graceful.
I'll never get to see this game.
There was also a rainbow behind him, so it's so magnificent.
Double rainbow, oh my god!
Look at it!
What does it mean?
Look at all the water graphics.
Please contain your orgasms.
Graceful, like a swan.
Also, at 30 FPS.
Also, they could...
Also, suddenly placing a replacement eye for you. We
didn't know to put that yeah. turns out that we couldn't afford...
Duct tape.
Like the
spent
eye...
spent all the budget on your chin, and we didn't have anything left for your eye.
Not even
yeah,
the...
kind of ran out of pieces at the last minute. So.
Yeah, like wasn't even the chin. It was just everything else. After everything else, they said they were going to do the eye last.
Wait. Find the cat.
Yeah.
The cat.
Where's the cat? I think it's past the pier. Or the stairs. Meow. Wait, there it is.
Meow. Now cut it. Split it wide open.
I do hate cats.
Damn. That is one cool cat.
I can't.
That one.
That cat is the actual protagonist.
Damn. Fuck you.
Bullshit. Yeah. I mean,
your skills are not good enough.
That's an unwinnable boss right there. Shit.
Yeah.
Hardest boss in this game.
See, that's why Kojima is even Konami. Slashes. They wanted Metal Gear Solid 6 to feature the cat as the main protagonist, but he wouldn't let them.
Yeah.
So they fired him. So now they can make
fire him. He quit.
So they can make the Metal Gear cat game that they always wanted. Also, by the way, we're killing
people. Don't even joke about that. Konami's actually doing something with
that.
What?
Cat.
Well, I'm joking.
Oh, okay.
I just want to bring up the fact that Konami's not moving on to dating sims and mobile apps.
That'd be great.
Well,
Konami has always made dating sims.
Yeah, but now they're actually focusing on it. They're legitimately driving off.
You've been caught!
Actually, no. Like the entire team that worked on like their dating sim left the fucking company. They're the ones that are focusing on dating sims because they started their own group.
I heard they actually, like,
you missed.
Shut up.
They're quitting console games entirely.
That doesn't make any sense because they're already saying that they're gonna fucking make more Metal Gear Rising games.
They said they might.
No, they said that it was a confirmed statement that they made.
When?
I think it was in March or something.
I think Kamar still should take notes from Metal Gear Rising because Metal Gear Rising seems to have the opposite problem that Kamar's 2 has when it comes to, like, reacting commands. Like, This game has the same thing, but, you know, it's a bit more engaging. You kind of have to activate yourself. On the other hand, not very interesting to look at. Like, I mean, yeah, it's cool the first time you do it, but, you know,
the first time you do it, it's cool.
Yeah, in March 2015, Konami released a statement that they have already resulted of new Metal Gear games.
Are you sure they're not talking about Phantom Pain? That is the new Metal Gear games.
They're talking about after Phantom Pain, after Kojima leaves. And Kojima stated that he more or less doesn't care.
He's probably working on something else.
How long until Kickstarter spiritual successor to Metal Gear?
Yeah.
Yeah, pretty much. But
started Kickstarter. This is not Metal Gear. This is called, I don't even know what to name it. This would be called Project Kojima. It features three playable
characters. Iron Cog.
God damn it,
Nate! Stop reading my thoughts. I was thinking
Iron Cog Liquid.
Oh, God.
You play as Liquid.
The Revolver Ocelot. It's
oh.
No, Revolver Oshawott.
No.
Solid Snivy.
It's not the crossover you want. It's the crossover you deserve.
It's a crossover you never knew you wanted and so don't want.
Yeah. I still don't deny it either.
What?
That he's gonna kickstart his own experience.
So pretty much like what happened with Mega Man and Mighty Number 9, I think it is.
There's one more too.
And Rare.
Remember. Huh? Rare. Oh, Rare and not Banjo-Kazooie.
Yeah. Oh yeah, ukulele. You get it?
Yes. Ukulele? Yes, I get
like
it.
Banjo?
No.
I don't get it. Get it?
Get it?
Plus Brett.
Bratwurst.
The fuck.
The only problem is that the other animal.
When I show, when I say Hillshire, you say Farms. Hillshire.
Cows.
But their names together.
Yeah, their names together make up one instrument. But Banjo-Kazooie, they had two. Oh, I see. There's some. There are some cutbacks.
Oh god. Perfect game to say that for.
When did this shit start? The whole slow walking thing.
This game.
No, this is a thing.
No, this has been a thing since
Gears of War.
Oh, I thought you were talking about for Metal Gear.
Like, I understand that you're in the middle of like chainsawing a demon in half, so how about you spend like a good minute walking and talking?
Well, at least you can shut them up.
Yeah, at least you can shut them up, though. Not now. And then you probably go back to chainsawing monsters in half. I don't care what fucking game you have.
But,
you're
but
not
yeah,
a machine gun with a chainsaw.
You can't speed up the text, but it's like, why am I even...
But yeah, noob. Kojima responded to that statement saying that like, he has, like, you know, confirmed that yeah, like, any other games Konami works on are, you know, going to be without him. Yeah. And that even if they do, you know, fulfill on that and keep going, he won't consider them Metal Gear games.
Kill him from up here.
Like, as far as he's concerned, Phantom Pain is the last Metal Gear game.
Oh. But I heard they were actually stripping his name from that, which is going to suck.
Oh, okay. There it is.
You got him?
Yeah! I don't think they're stripping his name from that. I think that's the one thing that they are keeping him on.
No one would buy it if it didn't say Kojima.
Yeah, exactly. That's why they canceled that new Silent Hill.
Yeah. That thing that everybody's angry about, including me, kind
of. Who wouldn't be?
Silent Hill's the fucking granddaddy of horror.
I've never played Silent Hill, so I could really give less of a shit.
It's scarier Resident Evil. Because there's a man that really hates geometry and really hates you.
No more Pyramid Head?
No, he probably wasn't even going to be in it. But, like, apparently it showed, like, real promise and people were fans. If you want to play a fucking Silent Hill game, I don't recommend it unless you got a diaper nearby. But people say start on 2. You definitely start on 2.
Hey, so you started on 2. Yeah, because that was that thing. Because it was that teaser called PT. Hey, Blaze. Yeah. By the way, we're recording right now.
I did see you walking earlier.
Yeah.
What happened? I did see you walking earlier.
Was that with a black girl?
Yeah.
That
was me.
So yeah, Blaze is here.
I'm gonna be a nig and scream from the train.
Should have been.
But yeah, we're recording the Metal Gear for the channel.
Oh, okay. That's what's up.
Special guest.
Yeah, special guest Blaze. Even though we've already recorded him in another video, this video will be uploaded first. So technically, this is his first appearance on the channel.
Yeah.
Hooray for continuity errors.
Continuity. He followed me a little bit down.
Never. I still don't get the joke.
Continuity. The actual pronunciation versus continuity.
You didn't pronounce the word before.
Yeah.
Oh.
I didn't know the actual pronunciation.
God damn it,
hey,
Juan.
What are you doing being sneaky?
I'm actually trying to save this guy this time.
No, fuck him. Fuck everybody.
It's almost impossible to save people in this game.
Just up and say fuck you, everybody. Let him die.
No. You responded! He's dead.
Dead. Look at That was quick. Yo, he took a long time to die.
Now see, if only he had the skills of that cat earlier.
Yeah, if only he could just backflip swords and bullets and stuff.
So are you just, like, dragging out their intestines and absorbing them or something?
Oh, well, that's their spines.
Their spines have some kind of fluid I can absorb.
Nanopaste!
Alright, man!
Nah, it's clearly Mountain Dew Baja Blast.
Yeah.
Like, real lightning.
Hilarious. And original.
Yeah, eat lightning and crap thunder.
Original the character, do not steal. By the way.
Oh, God.
The gecko cows.
He did not miss leg day.
Oh, yeah.
It's terrible.
But he skipped out of our day a couple times.
So, like, is that another Metal Gear that should be a big deal?
I think they're one of the little Metal Gears from the first game. Oh. Okay.
So he's a grunt gear?
I love that stock
change. Probably not even made out of metal.
Why is it mooing?
I don't know.
Why is it a fucking cow?
It's symbolism.
Or is it like
it's mooing.
It's
a straight up moo.
No, it literally
is
mooing.
Literally mooing.
That's retarded. It moos and yet tries to kick you in the dick.
And it's called a gecko.
Yeah, and it's a gecko too.
Does it have insurance?
Life insurance, maybe.
I would guess so.
That was a Geico joke, by the way.
Yeah.
Now, how about you actually fight the boss, KO?
That's not a boss. That's a basic enemy.
Well, in this instance, it seems to be like a mini boss.
Yeah, in this instance, but literally, like, not even a step ahead, they're going to send you against three of these things.
Triangle!
Like, this isn't even a mini boss. It's like, oh yeah, I hope you remember this, because this is going to be really important in like a second.
Right, I'm saying.
You know, for an Android type guy, I thought the game would have been a lot faster. I understand you go through like those little sort of like slow motion sequences that you're know, supposed to make you see and train like that, but gameplay is really slow.
Yeah.
It gets slower during bigger boss fights and later on when you got upgrades.
Especially when you get
slower, you
said? No, I said that by accident.
I was about to say, what the fuck?
Yeah, this game may seem hype right now, but it's actually a stealth game.
Yeah.
You gotta play the entire game really stealthy, otherwise you just get F's.
This game is actually really slow, and we've actually sped up the footage for the viewers.
Yeah, like 300%. Boom.
At six.
Did you notice like it's
at 120 FPS?
For a second.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's stock footage.
Oh.
You were caught.
Oh. No, like,
Steve.
No crouch or anything?
No, this isn't a crouch.
Buying boxes?
Dude, I was joking. This is a stealth game. This game just has stealth kills.
God,
it's a hack and slash, dude. The other Metal Gear games are stealths.
Sweetie, sweetie.
Nice camera.
Yeah. Mm. That sure was a box.
You go there.
There's a grenade there.
Ow.
Nothing stealthy about that.
So that was delicious. Stealthy. Why?
What the fuck happened?
Go get the grenade, KO.
Up. Press up. Damn it.
Get that one
from
there.
Above. Oh, that.
Split it wide open.
His legs are disturbingly slender.
Man.
What do I cut? Cut in the red square!
There you go!
Cool it.
And now you are the dead.
I just gotta respect the pouch.
To think they'd have more poses for that.
No, it's above just you. The one.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's like, same thing.
It's Sailor Moon.
The incredible stock footage.
Yeah.
Sailor Moon has it too.
Yeah, I know. That's
oozing stock footage.
That's the point that I was making.
Sailor Moon is stock footage.
That's the joke.
That's the joke, Dewan.
Good.
That's the joke I was making when I said Sailor Moon. Like,
you know you can slice in other ways other than horizontal. See, he gets it.
Yeah, you don't get to chop it off. You get to chop it in half. That's triangle.
Exactly. See, if I slice chop it in half. If I slice it vertically and chop it in the dick, I'll also be chopping it in the head so they won't feel like they'll be dead.
Well, that's why you gotta go upwards.
That's why you stop.
That's why Gears of War lets you do that.
You just leave the sword. You walk away like, have fun with that.
Congratulations, have fun.
You're being lying.
You may think this is painful, but really, you just gave me a brand new dick.
Yeah, for a cybernetic dude, like, he should add some melee skill.
He has a nice
Unfortunately, chance. He was,
self-taught.
Dude, what?
Oh, yeah, right.
Yeah, he has the same moveset as in here.
Oh, yeah, he was in that game, wow.
Except he just doesn't have, like, that rampage shit.
Technically, that's later.
Yeah, that's later.
Really?
Yep.
Wait, in this game, or are you talking about All-Stars?
In this game.
I was talking about All-Stars.
Oh.
The chin.
Chin. Damn it, I just paid for that.
That happens like 3 times.
Yeah.
The chin of truth. Insert for the parents jokes here.
No.
Okay.
Justice.
I'm so cool.
Also, this here happens like six or seven times too.
I understand you chop the trash can in half and whatnot, But shouldn't it still just fall straight down and slam you either way?
Technically, yeah.
That's the problem.
How's it fall sideways?
Physics.
Even with the amount of force from a blade, that's not enough.
Are you kidding, man? Have you tried to chop a trash can in half? When you apply enough force, it just explodes.
Yeah, newbie, no, he reads Snapple Caps.
Yeah, I know.
Damn. That's like getting your facts off the back of the Oreo box.
Still more trusted than Wikipedia.
I'm never letting him live that down. We're talking about Toho, talking about Patchouli. No, like, no, vitamin A deficiency, I think it was.
Yeah, vitamin A deficiency, that's where I came in. You see, I know this. When you guys are lacking vitamin A, I will tell you to eat polar bear livers. You will still die, but you can thank me that you at least died with vitamin A than without it.
Yeah, he told us that polar bear liver has so much vitamin A in it that eating it will kill you.
Yeah, it's lethal.
And I was like, where the hell did you find out that from?
Snapple.
What if I eat 1/4 of it?
You'll only die 1/4 of the way.
I think it's like a teaspoon that can kill you.
Oh, that's bullshit.
Damn.
Just your arm will die. The rest
of
you will be fine.
Yeah, just an arm. You don't need that arm, do you?
Your left arm specifically.
You can cut it off, grow a new one.
You have to plant
like
it first.
A homeless person, attach it. Although, if you do that, then kill him, he'll possess you.
So,
shut up! We're not playing that game yet.
Somebody sent a dog at me.
Arf!
It's here now, I guess.
Dogs in my...
Don't worry. Later in the game, he'll become your best friend.
Also, why the hell do machines feel the need to work?
Why is that dog thing feel the need to bark?
Why does it feel the need to chainsaw you?
Well, you see, they installed the voice really late, so he's really just taking up the opportunity. I didn't used to be able to talk before. Now I can. Is it easy? Yeah.
I don't know how he's talking.
Lock on!
Maybe everything he's saying is pre-recorded.
It is a possibility.
And everybody, and the person who recorded his voice knew exactly what he would say. At
was
all
he
times.
Or
knew exactly what was going to go down.
Yeah. Wait, what did you say? Okay.
And as you can see here, the dog gets tired of fighting you, so he sends some snacks after you.
Oh, look, food.
Yeah.
Friends are sending friends.
How did you know? I love Kool-Aid.
Those dogs can swing pretty hard if they push you back.
That is true.
And double Kool-Aid. Delicious.
Anybody else like how they were floating upwards?
Yeah.
Only Jetstream Sam, when you play as him, does that.
What?
Sad.
What?
He actually shish kebabs the spines.
Right.
Wait, you can play as him?
Kool-Aid.
DLC.
Do you have that?
Yeah.
Yay.
We have that, and then we have the one we play as the dog.
Uh-oh.
That's a thing?
Yes.
Yeah.
Is
he a dog?
Yeah, that dog right there.
Why?
Why not? Look at that dog. He's got a chainsaw for a chainsaw.
He
uses his tail to play with the chainsaw, so I couldn't really finish that correctly.
Oh yeah! It's not actually part of his tail.
By the way, if you couldn't tell, this game is kind of hard.
Well, I'm playing it hard.
That's it.
Oh, you are?
Yeah.
I couldn't tell.
Hard. That's how you know you have hard
you
game.
To play Shadow in the
what?
I've seen that.
Dude, I love it. The game's really good. This is how it plays. First portion, you go through your story mode, figure out what exactly happened between you and the guy you're linked with, which is pretty much Dead Elf King. So since both you two were killed the exact same way in that game, you know, you're connected and you're both in his realm where you're banished from death and whatnot, blah, blah, blah. But anyways, you go around killing, like, orc commanders and shit and, like, ranking up in the system, trying to find, first people for the Black Hand and whatnot. But after you get past the first Black Hand portion, you get a second portion of the game where you're following this one lady to help you like end it all and whatnot. But instead, she had this staff where she was being possessed and shit, so they were just giving you false orders to help the demon out anyway. Because you go about, you possess now captains, which you can upgrade to war chiefs. So this game goes from, oh yeah, I'm killing off like every goblin war chief, whatnot, just gonna be a badass about it, to now you gotta create your own army out of these guys. This is the epic part about the game. It does have a little monster ranch system, because every single goblin, every single orc, commander, or regular enemy fight has logistics to it. but only the commanders actually have big statistics. But after a normal goblin kills you, they become a commander.
I'm still a little pissed off about that.
And this is what I mean by skills. They'll have normal skills where they'll show off what they're weak to. So if they're scared to beast, they'll show. If they can die from stealth, they'll show. If they can die from archery, they'll show. Same thing with melee finishers. But then they'll have extra skills such as, like, impervious to melee strike. So you cannot kill them with a melee combo. When you go to finish a melee combo, they'll fend it. There are certain ones that are counterproof, so you can't counter their moves. There are certain ones, like my favorite one that I have under my possession at the moment, he has heavy hitter, so all his hits do extreme damage. He has widespread, so every strike he does hits in a wide radius. He has multi-strike, which means every single one of his hits have to be countered separately. And then he has anti-counter, he cannot be countered. Like beat shit out of everything.
So is that a mobile game or
no?
It's 360. And the best part about like his skill set, he has bloodthirsty. Every time he lands a strike, he gains health.
Dude,
so multi hit and widespread and heavy hitter, he doesn't go down for shit.
Sounds like an Elder Scrolls style RPG.
Kinda, except it's way better than Elder Scrolls. Like the fight style, way better. There's not much magic involved.
You realize you probably just pissed off like the entire like everyone who's ever gone on the internet ever.
On the damn comments, like I care. I only show up once in a blue moon. Fuck y'all. Right. Anyways, the game shit is ridiculously fun.
Oh yeah. Definitely.
Oh yeah. Like I was saying, the only way you launch special skills, like you see your combo thing right there. You gotta of course do combos and whatnot. You can go into swarms and literally beat ass through a whole crowd of people. But as your combos go up, they'll turn red, which alerts you to know that you can use a special. Whether it be a melee like finisher, whether it be a drain finisher, you can even go into your archery mode where you can fire a fire arrow at him and burn him. The game's really sick, though. Like, if you're into like this type of fight style, you should go for that game. Because there's a bit more than just the kill everything.
Oh yeah, I've heard, man. I've heard so much about that game.
Like, that game's easy and difficult at the same time. It's easy because if you know what you're doing, you can go through and just brutalize a bunch of orcs. It gets difficult when you try to fight captains and war chiefs and have no information on, so you know none of their weaknesses at all. So you can come up, try to fight them, try to land a stealth kill to finish them. They can be stealth-proof, knock you straight to the floor and just whoop your ass. And some of them can have gang leader, which means they're always following their pack. And as they strike you, of course, you have little, you know, obstacles and nuisance that keep on striking you. And you can't counter everything.
Don't even get me started on that, not knowing what weaknesses are in fucking Shin Megami Tensei 4. We go like, maybe I should use lightning. Reflects back at you, kills one of your demons. Well, fuck.
Right, man.
There's no watch behind it either. Like, their weakness, whatever the fuck they feel like. Demon thing. Maybe I should use light on it. Right? Nothing reflects it.
Yeah, like
fucking.
Oh!
Gonna rape
you! That's why you're sitting around by the umbilical cord.
God damn it.
Hello?
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 Yeah. That's lights already.
Split them wide open.
I got partial spoiler.
Oh yeah. From what I've heard about Shadows of Mordor, actually, maybe just talking about, was that when people were getting early copies to review the game, apparently they were being like really restrictive of what they could and couldn't do with the gameplay footage and what they could and couldn't say about the game.
Mm-hmm.
And people they were being so like overbearing that people were losing their minds about trying to record it. It's like, or trying to review it. It's like, I want to review this game because this game is good, but you people are acting like serious dicks. Oh no, it's a solid, like, I'm pretty sure that's like a 9 out of 10 game, maybe even 10 out of 10 game. It wouldn't surprise me. It's a game, like, if we can, we need to play it too. It's definitely worth
the with the Xbox 360, we have just sitting over there not being used.
Shh, they don't know that! Yeah. It's not 360.
Finally!
It might be a PS3.
I can believe that.
Jump that bitch-ass up into bitch-ass pieces, bitch.
I was hoping you just cut off his blade.
Oh yeah, just chop off the chainsaw. Not what you got.
Only they had a shank option. Stab him in the head and leave him be. Waste the rest of the slow motion time just running in circles. Inhaled him in the head like, whack!
Unfortunately, we do not have the physics engine for stab.
We don't need to stab, but we can cut their heads off.
Kale has joined the guild.
Yeah, there was a PS3 version of
Shadow Guys. I still have not opened my Attack on Titans game. So
what the heck?
Yeah, I wanted to share with you guys and enjoy the experience with me.
There's something that's happening.
I haven't touched it.
Oh yeah, there's that too.
Capture is currently processed. Please stop capture before
family issues popped up.
So it's still going?
They have a game?
Yeah, dude, it came out for the DS. It's only a
eShop
DS download at the moment. It's
what the hell?
I didn't get to play yet, so I don't know if it's worth getting. But me, myself, my girlfriend bought it for me, so I didn't really care. I was just happy as how to get Attack on Titan base game. If this thing blows up here, we're definitely looking at home consoles, for sure.
Yeah.
And you already know once it touches home consoles, the mechanics on the game, the graphics on the game, everything's going to expand, including multiplayer. It's going to be amazing. I was pissing people off in Xenoverse. Dragon Ball Z.
No.
I made an entire female specialist class that's human. So humans, naturally, when they're fighting, their energy goes up. Their ki rises normally. I run Saiyan Raised on Earth, which is E-Soul for it. When your ki is full, your stamina rapidly raises. So I can warp around, beat shit out of you with physicals. I run a decent amount of physical, and then everything else in special. I run Super Kamehameha, or Perfect Kamehameha Wave, and then I run No More Games, which is a Cell ability. Whenever he uses Super Spirit Bomb or Super Kamehameha Wave, he becomes invincible, and it does significant amount of damage.
Dude, that is busted.
So, all that special power already on her, her class and her size and gender make her the best in ki.
So,
and
do we still
also, I have a set of just her ki up like fast as fuck. And I also run Kale Ken on her, because as I have full key, energy rises. Kale Ken will never drain.
Alright, get back to the capture.
Dude, I still want to play that shit.
Yeah, and when you're in Kale Ken times 20, your physicals do times 3 more, so your special attacks. So, go Kale Ken, then it's like Super Kamehameha. If you're in the fucking way, you're dead. If you throw an ultimate, I'ma just throw an ultimate in your face, eat yours up, and kill you.
Delicious.
Dude, I destroyed someone that had...
The magically delicious.
Health, which is the highest. What you doing online?
Yeah, I was playing people online, doing 3v3s and shit, just blowing people out the water with a Super Kamehameha Wave. I would run up to people running stuff like Supernova, running, what's that other thing called? Vanishing Death Ball. You know, they would just try to fly in my face and hit me with it. They did like Super Kamehameha Wave. They hit me with it, and then they're still in the animation of launching while I'm there charging it. Like, you see their health bar.
The only thing I remember about you and DBZ games is that one game we played for the Wii. It was one of the DBZ game fighting games for the Wii. Yeah, that one. I remember playing that against you, and you kept beating my ass with that one guy. I think it was Super 17 or something.
Oh yeah. That was for PS2, Tenkaichi Budokai 3. I ran Android 17 and Super 13. Those were like my favorite.
Yeah, Super 13.
I want anybody's ass to Super 13. I don't care. I got the hang of eating up ultimates with them and everything.
Hey. I played that. A Burger Smash.
Right. But I still know it's muscle.
Yeah,
so
I'm
going to
borrow
it. I'm going to just shatter people.
Damn you.
That game, dude, I was able to do like 57 hit combos. If you didn't know how to perfect guard, your ass was raped. It was that serious.
In Xenoverse, I run a similar set with Super Drain and Shining Slash.
I run Super Drain as well. If you're going to run Shining Slash, run that one thing. What the hell is that thing called? Instant Transmission. Not the regular one, the attacking one. After Image Strike. There we go. You get it from Goku with training from him. You got to be level 70 to train under him. It's the first move he gives you. You basically teleport everywhere like a joke. But the thing is, in between each teleport, you can interrupt it with a special skill.
Oh.
And if you time it on the third one when you're close to them, you actually end up behind them. So you can use it, end up behind them, super drain them, and then as you smack them away, you can warp behind them and just continue on the ass whooping.
I didn't know that. They don't tell you that you can't
do that. No, you gotta learn how to play that game, seriously. Even though, like, the physical combo game is doo-doo, there's so many fucking ways you can link that shit up, especially with specials.
Yeah, there's like infinite shit. That's like, what Super Drain is for. Like,
right, I have a Frieza class that runs Milky Cannon, yo. That thing is a
Milky Cannon.
You don't want to play against that.
The hell is Milky Cannon?
Milky Cannon's a tricky move because it's kind of like Big Bang where you throw a ball and it'll blow up. But the thing is, that's a move that only blow up halfway, it'll never reach across the stage. And when you throw it, you hold down the launch button, and when you release it, it explodes. So you can be very gimmicky with that move. Right, Ganyu's pretty nasty. I ran a retarded suicide class where I run that Holsten shock, and I run this one skill where you gain a lot. It's a cell second form where you get a bunch of statistics, but when you're low on health, all your statistics drastically drop. So you Holsten strike over and over till you get to like very low health where your skill kicks in and all your statistics drain. Then you body switch with your opponent so they have
good job, KF.
And then you just hit them once and it's over. Yeah.
That is classic as shit.
It's gay. It's I do it for people that game. Like to spam, you know?
Game?
It's like the Shuckle with Power Split.
Oh my god.
Oh no. Oh
god. Jesus.
It's worse than that, to be honest.
Well, yeah, because you're lowering everything other than just attack.
That's what it wants to do to you.
Anywhere, but run away. Oh, I found a pretty good combo for that Shine Ball thing you were talking about. So, you know how Shine Ball gets summoned and brings out, of course, a lot more and all that?
I talk about the combo with Agent of Creation Venus.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Oh, Yu-Gi-Oh. I'm like, what
so, you could do all that, and you could still run Human Body Wave, I think it's what it's called. Something like that. That one Moki Moki card. Whenever a normal monster is destroyed on your side of the field, you can splash someone to level 2 or under.
Uh-huh.
Equip Nano Paste.
Yeah, you can run that with a lot of other small fairy types. Run Honest, and then you can run Blade of Sacrifice, I think it's called. When you equip it to a normal monster, tribute all other normal monster on your side of the field.
Fairy tribute monster gains 1,000.
Oh, yeah, the Sword of the Soul Eater, I think it's called, right? Yeah,
that's what it's called, Soul of Soul Eater.
Yeah, I used to run that card in a normal deck I had.
That card's amazing. I almost got knocked out on YGL Pro by that.
YGL Pro.
I'm building the Arrow Mages.
The what?
The Arrow Mages.
I'm sorry, I don't keep up on Yu-Gi-Oh! No
more. They're a plant deck for life game.
Oh my god, I saw the stupidest thing when I was on the Yu-Gi-Oh! Wiki the other day. You know Pendulum Monsters?
I'd rather not talk about those.
No. There's a Pendulum Xyz monster.
Great.
How does it even?
Yeah.
It's like I'm half magic, half triple card. I don't like exceeding, like, all like that. I use it when I have to, just for, like, the 1K effect. But, I mean, other than that, I just prefer to use the normal
deck slotted.
So, is that plant deck focused on special?
The Armages? No, they normal summon a lot.
Oh,
I mean,
okay.
You could splash in Lone Fire, but they're primarily normal summon.
Okay, and what's their statistics at?
There's one boss monster, but it's all like, once you get field established, it's kind of over.
I'm just wondering how that would play against, like, that Steel March deck I have.
I don't know.
Because I played that deck so far against, like, a lot of other decks, and...
Yeah, that thing wrecks.
And on, this thing,
The Dueling Network?
Yeah, I played that deck a lot on both of those, and so far I haven't ran into any trouble. The only trouble I ever run into is when they want to dick me and give me a handful of magic trap. Then I'm sitting there like, wow. And then the next 3 cards I get are like my biggest monsters. And it's like, wow, thank you, YGO Pro.
Yeah, that's how it goes whether you're playing for real, YGO Pro, Dueling Network, the video game.
Like, it's literally impossible to make a deck where no matter what hand you get, it's perfect. I mean, there's some decks like that, but that's why there's ban lists and that's why those decks are shitted on now.
Yeah.
It's literally a bunch of nonsensical life game.
The only fucking deck that I ever played that was so good, no matter what hand you got, had to be E-Dragons. That was it. And that's why they got smashed completely.
I was about to say, isn't that like the entire point of an Exodia deck?
No, Exodia decks are actually pretty trash, unless, they're mainly gimmicky.
Yeah.
Yeah, but aren't they all about trying to get everything perfect in the hand?
Well, kind
of. You have to get all 5 cards of Exodia in the hand, and then you win.
Yeah,
most Exodia decks don't even focus on getting the Exodia pieces in hand. They mainly focus on
the stall
or the rapid support to try to reach it to your hand quick as possible.
Or it's just a normal deck that just has Exodia in it.
You see really stupid Magical Library Bamboo Sword shenanigans.
I've done that.
Magical Library bullshit.
The
even I dropped a Veiler on it next week.
That's why they fucking we're in Magic Library. That's why they banned fucking what's that card? That's why they banned Butterfly Dagger Alma.
Yeah.
Like get Gilfried the Iron Knight and Warrior Magic Library on the field and get Butterfly Dagger on your hand, you win.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
You didn't. Butterfly Dagger. You
Butterfly Dagger to this dude. He can't be equipped, so it's destroyed. Gets some to graveyard. Butterfly's effect goes back to your hand. Your library gets a point.
So you just
you constantly doom and counter. Your counters just reach infinite. You can draw until you get your game.
Well, it stops at three, but essentially stops three. I spend three to draw one card, equip, and you just keep going.
It doesn't stop at three. You can do it as much as you want, but you only get three counters for
it. You may as well just sit.
That's why you run Citadel, so you constantly stack.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's why Butterfly Dagger Elma is banned, and is essentially why I don't like playing Yu-Gi-Oh that much.
That's why I ran that type of Exodia deck. I always ran, like, the trump card. Fucking Magical Explosion.
Oh, my God.
Every magic card, 200. I don't play that.
Like, I just... I don't know. But the ban list is one of the reasons why I don't like playing Yu-Gi-Oh.
Truth be told, I kind of like it, kind of don't. Because, I mean, if there wasn't one... anytime you ever wanted to play, like, I guess, a professional game.
A serious match or professional
game. Yeah, serious match. You just get thrown out the water.
Well, it's not even that I don't like the ban list itself. It's just that... It's only certain decks. It's only, like, the decks that are good, and then those get hit, and then those people specifically have to rebuild their decks, while everyone else is just fine sitting there with the decks the same way as they always were.
I was one of those people that complained at first, but then again, I started to see the light. Because, you remember that, that Synchro, Laval deck I made?
Mm-hmm.
That deck got hit for me, because it dropped, my three rekindles down to one. So, I understand that, because, I mean, with three rekindles, that is just... No. And then with three gold sarks, that is just no. Because, I mean, all you do is gold sark any of your plays, go Laval Cannon, and then it's over because you sink in that one move. And on top of that, rekindle is just too much. It goes pretty much, first move, I'm a rekindle, get my monsters. You go Toriento, it's like, cool, whatever, I'm a rekindle again. Yeah. It goes, I negate your card. It goes, okay, cool, rekindle once more, still game over. I mean, with three rekindles, I mean, you're just... You're safe no matter what. You're safe. Even if they Toriento Dark Hole, even if they remove your shit, LaVals can still play. So that's why I agreed with the rekindles being gone and the gold sarks being down the line as well.
And then there's games like Magic where there is no ban list and you can use whatever the fuck you want.
There are ban lists.
Really?
You have to keep up with the sets.
Exactly like Pokemon.
Okay, then. I prefer the way Pokemon and Magic do it, where it has to be from, like, the most recent sets, because that way everyone is kind of forced to stay within, like, the same realm.
Could you imagine if Yu-Gi-Oh was that way?
I would like that, I would agree with that, but also allowing to bring older generation cards into the newer generation, because, I mean, I do like how you do play
the way that they do it that way means that certain Pokemon species can't be played at all.
Yeah, exactly. That's
what I know that, I think it's for this year or starting next year, they're adding a separate competitive tournament format where you can use the black and white cards as well.
Oh.
Well, you can use the black and white era cards. Like, I think it's...
So any set that was released black-white.
Yeah, I think it's only black and white era cards for that format, but I guess because people enjoyed the black-white format so much, they just decided to do that.
Hey, that's what's up. I just don't like the idea of, like, black cards and knowing that eventually I won't be able to do that.
That's what I just think as well.
But isn't it like every few years?
No, it's like every couple months.
Actually. Every year. Like once a year once a year after the TCG Worlds, they bring in the new list of sets that are getting cycled out.
But you know, it's good and bad because Pokemon, they cycle out certain sets is the thing. Because you can actually keep playing with a deck for probably 3 years at most. Before he gets cycled out completely.
And plus, Pokemon almost constantly like reprints a lot of the better cards.
Exactly.
Either the same exact thing, or just under a different name.
Exactly.
Like there's always going to be cards like in Professor Juniper, Professor Sycamore, that do the same thing, just under a different name.
Exactly.
Match the current,
there's even
Jane.
Monsters that even, not monsters, Pokemon that get dropped in more than one set. For instance, like Landorus. Landorus has two cards that are basically the same, except one has 100 HP, one has 110. One has Sky Lariat, while the other one has Gaia Hammer. A Sky Lariat does 90, Gaia does 80, even though they're literally the same requirements. Then the next move, I think, is like Shout of Power or something. They cost exactly the same and do the exact same amount of damage.
Yep. Only difference is one card has 10 more, one has 10 less. Reasons why? Because this set that he was printed in, it seemed fair to use him in that set. Next set, he needs a bit more help because he's going against bigger competition. Now it's like, you gotta go against shit like Megas and whatnot.
Ah, Megas.
300 HP in a Pokemon training card game.
Woot! And being able to do 220 damage one straight.
Woot!
Oh!
That is true!
Mega Heracross EX.
Remember back in the day when 120 was good?
Right. Yeah. Remember back in the day, all you needed was that $100 Charizard and it was like, yeah, GG.
$100 Charizard and Blaine's Arcanine. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
The fucking Charizard killer.
Oh, and then don't forget the Zapdos with the 160 damage potential.
Oh, this thing, Dark Jolteon, was just godly back in the day.
Remember all the random,
I still have one of those, actually.
Like, all the random special types of cards that they print for once and then just completely forgot about.
Hey, Kale, if you get into Pokemon, you're going to want to stack up on this one Eevee. It's Pokebody. Well, no, it's called Pokebody or Pokepower. It's color changed. Whatever energy you place on, evolves immediately.
What?
Yeah.
Oh, I remember that.
He just came out like a couple of seconds ago.
This is the ruling in Pokemon. Once you evolve, you can't attack. Because of that Poke ability, you're still allowed to.
Wow.
So, this is the combo I came up with. Oh,
you can still evolve. You can only do it once per turn for Pokemon.
And it's, I think, after you attack. Or something.
No, there's no limit. You just have to do it. You just evolve one Pokemon.
Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah, if it evolves, it can't attack. I know that for a fact.
No, you can still attack.
You sure?
Yeah, you can still attack.
Yeah, I remember what it was. I remember it's really good for something because you're allowed to evolve and go right in. But the combo I go with it, I give it a Leaf Energy, and then it goes right into Leafeon. Leafeon's first move that costs one Leaf Energy is called Grass Whistle. 10 damage, you're asleep. Instantly.
Oh, one of those.
Chance. Instant.
Damn.
Yep. Yeah, so it's like right off the bat, I'm about to hurt.
That is evil.
Oh, wait, I think the limitation you're thinking of is when you place down a Pokemon, you can't evolve it on that turn.
That's what it is, yes. When you place a Pokemon down, you cannot evolve it that turn, but because of that Poke ability, you can.
Damn.
You can equip it with any energy, and it comes from your deck, too.
You search your deck for it.
Go on, Espeon.
Fucking instant.
No. Oh, wait, does it say you have to shuffle later? Because you already get a free look at your deck, then.
Yeah, of course, but you do have to shuffle after repeat.
Okay, fair
Unless
enough.
Unless it's cards that are like Professor Oak, where it says reveal top, you know, select certain, and then put back in any order. Okay, Brodies, I'll talk to y'all later.
Nate out.
Who's left?
You lost in person.
That was Nate and...
Oh, no, not again! Okay, we're back on.
Alright, once again, technical difficulties. Rock to us, big bitch.
God, you
you're making me hungry.
You really got me excited for pizza rolls.
Pizza.
I'm a fucking college student. Pizza rolls are
god.
What
the fuck is going on?
What just happened?
I don't know.
You ninja run too ninja'd. Run the other one!
What is going on?
Epicness! Enjoy it!
Sure. I think I like stayed in the area too long or something. Which caused that event to even happen?
Did you just do an optional mission?
I think I did. Not when you like go to the VR training to trigger either, it just happened.
Not just that. We can play that whenever we're not trying to play different games.
Oh, you could skip it. Or at least quicker.
You can speed up the dialogue.
The dialogue.
Dialogue.
Awesome that pop learned.
Huh? The Balrog.
The Balrog?
Balrog.
You can only cut certain gates. Huzzah!
Oh, yeah, something funny I might end up doing.
Oh no, the mini geckos.
There's a fighting game player who goes by Kira Ball, right? Obviously, you know where we're at. And you play Ball, and you know how they call it. Now, I guess he started like a chain of other players who do the same thing. And for some strange reason, particularly Ball Art players, who goes by the name of insert wherever country or country place they come from, Ball Art. That's their name. So I was thinking, hey, maybe I should learn Balrog, and since I live in Buffalo, I should go by the name of Buffalo Bison.
God damn it.
I don't get it.
Balrog. Balrog's
oh, you're talking about Street Fighter!
Yes, yeah, Street Fighter. I thought the word Balrog over and over again would catch the...
Do you not remember that I made a cave story joke?
I don't think...
I got it.
Oh, cave story.
Yeah, brought that back. Actually, I left it here yesterday. Right there.
I saw it. Yeah, go through it!
What is going on?
What's happening?
Oh. This game is a...
Can't even climb a simple step ladder.
This is durable ass cameras. I'm cutting through like human beings like butter, and yet this camera's like.
Actually, that's because human beings are nice and squishy and filled with meat.
Built to last, Duralast.
Yeah.
That door went down in one slice.
Not built to last.
Right, wait. There are active fire sensors in the area. Purple factory security, no doubt, but the enemy may be using it.
So yeah, we haven't talked about Metal Gear at all.
We talked about the shitty grin, that's all we needed.
I will admit, I love this game to death, but there isn't much to it.
Yeah.
Which is kind of like a common thing in most games I like.
Yeah,
it's simple.
Well, it's not just that, it's just like if you love it or not. Ring. I'm kind of sad that they don't do a remix of the Encounter song. Yeah, on the first Metal Gear. AKA the only song that I put on Shadow Moses in Brawl. No, it's just the only one that I actually like. Nope.
I don't even like that, really. I like the song. I don't like the smash. It doesn't fit.
It doesn't, but I love the song.
That's kind of what she said.
I guess I would also probably say Theme of Tara. That would be another song that I put on the stage. Don't know where it's from, other than Metal Gear.
More nuts.
So who else is pissed off that they were just all the music for 2 minutes?
I am.
Oh, yeah, because that ruins the DK rap.
Oh, yeah. Especially that one. Rap.
You want a nut?
A nut.
Like if those it ain't nuts. The original, I don't care.
Yeah, it's not bad. It isn't bad enough that we get a remix.
You need
to eat popcorn.
Quickly, find the box.
You don't see.
You want to find the box, huh? Not that kind of video, bro.
Ignore me.
Ignore me!
That camera was just sitting there watching.
Anybody else notice the rocket launcher that goes through off? Kill the camera.
Kill the man.
So who hopes they bring back Snake?
Oh, you got the arm.
I know what that is. Sense.
No, I want it broken still.
I didn't really want to
I found it fun to play when people weren't fucking
dancing
everywhere.
Yeah, unlike Meta Knight, he was the fun type of broken. Or at least high tier.
I don't think he was all that high tier, actually. Yeah, he was.
Yeah, he really was.
He had more kill potential than Meta
Knight. Damn.
Yeah, and not just that, but he's Ike with a projectile. Shit.
And at least with Ike, like, his kill potential moves are the obvious ones, you know, forward smash or shit like that.
Yeah.
Snake's moves are like...
Up tilt.
Like, yeah, he has this slow-ass forward smash that he can kill people, but no, that's not what you use to kill. What you use to kill people is an incredibly fast up tilt. And
any tilt?
Yeah, pretty much a tilt. It's forward tilt. It's fast as fuck, it kills way too easily. It was the hoo-ha before the hoo-ha. The hoo-ha was there.
Actually, all of his tilts were stupidly fast. Even his jab.
Well, his down tilt didn't really function.
His down tilt was so low to the ground, that was its problem.
Well, his up tilt is even lower to the ground.
It's also 5 feet in front of him.
Oh, yeah. And below him. And behind him.
Yeah, that's the worst part.
It's like a circle hitbox.
What?
Wait, it's what? Bullshit, that's what.
Yeah, imagine can, that.
Like, you can stand, like, 3 feet away from the edge and, like, up tilt somebody who's hanging onto the edge and spike them.
Yeah.
I don't know if you can do that with Luigi, but, like, it just doesn't.
Oh, and let's not forget, he has, like, one of the best neighbors in the game. Those multi-kicks.
Oh, yeah.
If you get hit by one of them, you're stuck in that.
I heard circular blocks in my mind just like, what?
The cards,
man. His up tilt can be from anywhere.
Chicken flavors be from it.
No, why? Never mind. No.
Oh, yeah, I was wrong about the whole, Easter egg with Tiger Boots.
Well, obviously, because you did it.
So, going into one of the highlights of Metal Gear Rising, the boss fights!
Ah.
Honestly, that's kind of the highlight for any game. So.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But this also has music.
Yeah, music. But that's what's in the boss fight, so I guess the boss fight.
I guess.
Look at which of those fuckers. My family's close. That's when I realized I am a killer too.
All this existential crisis stuff.
Follow your leg.
You mean in fact they're two different colors?
She went black.
Yeah, she's like bullying as hell.
To be honest, I found it quite dirty.
Yeah.
My enemies felt like dominoes.
I can feel something rising.
Stop this.
What I'm talking about. Without challenge, without purpose. At times, I even envied my friends.
At least they had the cost to die for. And then? Oh, him? Damn it.
Really? She's taking it.
They always are.
You're
always
going to take it again. Taken.
And I knew what I had been missing.
Why don't you leave him and be a lesbian?
His ideas gave my life meaning. Ideas, Jack. What are yours?
I protect the weak.
Still?
We can only spin in circles now.
Yeah.
Looks like she's about to take up arms.
Yes, play the wide open.
Not as bad as a compliment.
If you would kill for your ideals, then surely you are ready to die for them.
You really gotta give credit to the people who made this game. You really have to hand it to them.
Everybody give him a hand.
Pun.
Ah, she gave herself one.
That was the best one.
For their handiwork.
Knife to meet you.
Come on.
I guess she's a cut above the rest.
That was the Sam joke from before. Okay. This is much more. What do you guys think?
Sounds an awful lot like menstrual.
Why do you think everything? Why do you think her main motif is red?
I see.
Well, there's only like, well, okay, aside from the final boss, there's only like this chick. There's Monsoon.
Does he use water?
No.
No. Damn. Yes. No.
He uses fog, so if that counts, it counts.
Technically, yes.
Well, technically, everyone's theme is wind, so he still works with it.
This game blows.
Excellent!
Yeah, then the Sundowner and Jetstream Sound. Pretty much just four major bosses.
I don't understand Sundowner. I'm talking about the wind joke.
Yeah.
Let it wide open!
So yeah, out of the four, I would put her at like number three.
Is it the bottom?
The bottom I would put is
Oh yeah, his was the weakest looking of them.
He literally is the weakest, he has the least health on the wall.
And he's the boss?
He's a boss after her.
He's the boss after her and Monsoon. He said, really, number three is the weakest one.
Yeah, he's the boss before Sam.
Damn.
I might as well call him first.
Well, it was kind of leading up to it, but Sam interrupted.
Damn it, Sam.
Get all the candy!
That was the first one, though. God damn it.
They just want hugs.
Well, I would give them to them if they wouldn't just fucking not die.
Oh, they keep climbing. You're considering what they are, that's all they have.
Are you sure this game's really hard? She's acting really dumb.
Yeah, I'm confused. I think this game is glitching out or something.
I call this one hard just means fake difficulty.
Well, it's not like Kingdom Hearts where I just take more damage. It's supposed to be like more active during the fights and stuff.
Yeah, but you just see her, she was facing the wrong way and attacking.
Yeah, I don't know what's going on.
She did it again right there, actually.
Actually, she just did a long wind-up attack.
I thought she was attacking behind herself again.
No, see, it was that move.
Wow, this
is nice. Look at all that range.
Nothing.
Combo!
Ha! Heal! Fuck you! Damn it!
If anything, those little guys are a lot more aggressive.
Yeah, I haven't had this much of a problem before. And it's not even her, it's just these things. Maybe if we just add more of these things for her. Yeah, like right now, she was just tagging the wall.
Here you go, make her spaz.
I also don't like the whole wiggle the stick to shake him off you thing. It's like, it's very not...
not fun.
Very not fun. It's not a comfortable way to make me, like, try to get out of six situations. I'd rather just press a button.
Oh yeah, if they made it into a prompt.
Yeah. Kind of like brave functions. Like, my left hand on the controller is dedicated to movement and nothing else. If there's a command that involves something other than movement, I have to move to the right side of the controller.
Wait, isn't this when the vocals start kicking in?
Yes. The lyrics are not kicking. Stranger Art of Man is, I think, the name of the song. In terms of boss names, I put this at like number two. Out of the four.
Hey, which one was your one of the four?
One monster. I don't know. Game's the time, there we go.
Ah, yes. Uh-oh.
Oh, no, not actually.
What happens?
It's an unblockable one.
Yeah, she grabbed it.
Oh, 19 damage.
You say B?
A lot of it.
Damn.
How did I not recognize that? Fucking the final boss, since we're not gonna spoil that. Fucking, we were doing the Jetstream DLC, he kept hitting us with that.
Yeah.
Fucking
he actually finally
was he? Yep. He's the final boss of that too. He's the only boss. I'm the fucker. Ugh,
he's one of the two bosses.
What is the Jet DLC? You just play the game as Sam?
Yeah.
No, you play through a small story showing why Jet is waiting for the game.
And you fight
Spoiler.
Yeah.
And then when you beat him, he's like, hey, you got spunk, kid. So how about you join me, or I can just kill you, you know? And he's like, fuck it. I'd rather live.
I need food.
To be honest, though, like, fucking, that fight was really entertaining. I love this game. Simply because I love the action when you think about what you're doing.
Yes.
Technically, this right here is two androids with multiple arms. He makes them into staves and spears and shit. Versus a cyborg robot ninja.
And
in a burning in a burning oil rig. Oh, and it's not a rig. It's what's it?
The ultimate penis.
Yeah. What?
It's like
Expendables.
You know how girls have chick flicks?
Yeah, and then we have dick flicks. Yeah.
So you mean fan service?
Fan service.
This is the type of shit that we just eat up.
Yeah.
I don't know why, we just do.
So close, man.
This is so violent. If only we could talk to her. Oh, wait, you're already there.
Oh! New DLC for the dating sims that Konami's making.
Where what? We just talk to her.
Why not?
I mean, have you tried listening to how her day was?
Yeah.
It's over! Wow!
The camera. This has not been the smoothest playthrough.
Well, obviously, we have all those technical difficulties.
Everything but your... Oh, okay.
Worst!
Man, you need to keep it together, you're falling to pieces.
Just throw all that back.
That's the stuff that you're hanging
up.
I think an octopus.
Yeah, you just totally dissed
no,
it.
Wait,
you're
okay.
Just done. She's just kind of a pile on the floor now.
I like how they're dropping and not just dropped.
Did you not see him throw a giant robot fire at his bitch?
Did you not hear his mixtape?
Yeah.
Well, the last time Raiden had to deal with fire, he lost his arm.
He lost his arm already.
But that was because that was Jetstream's mixtape.
I got you right where I want you. So I'm gonna kill you by blowing
Kaboom!
Myself up on the opposite side of this battle.
Even the neighboring structures didn't even took
yeah.
a damage.
He set the fire on fire. I need to get out of here.
Well, I guess that's it for this part of the Metal Gear Rising Revengeance.
playthrough?
Yeah, we just cleared out this chapter. By we, I mean KO.
Yes.
Sorry that we talked about pretty much everything about this game, but this game is kind of have a very simple premise. You're a ninja, you kill shit. And,
yeah.
Once you get past that, not really much to talk about.
There's that whole gigantic backstory that Metal Gear Solid has started, but this isn't Metal Gear Solid.
Yeah, we just talk about this shit when we're actually playing Metal Gear Solid.
Yeah, pretty much the only thing we have left to talk about is actually what happens in the game as we play it, but as far as that goes, we have to get there first.
Yeah.
So, join us next time when we,
get there.
Well, have they established what we're doing next? Because the guy that we're going after is dead now, so,
that's what the next chapter is for.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. Join us next time. See you later.